be a Roadhog or do other things to try and isolate the problem that is Volataya, perhaps it would be Misfits. But on the same note, you also want to play as you practice. You don't want to go into a tournament as important as this and go to something that you haven't played as much. So we'll have to see. I think if Misfits ends up going down two rounds here or something, if they had something in mind, they'd probably swap to it by round three. Either way, though, we're opening up here on the Sanctimax.
And sadly, no Junkrat on Sanctum, no Orisa on Sanctum. The one map, the one stage that people have experimented a little bit on. It's gonna see pretty much mirror matches here as the dives will come in and see who gets the first kill.
Misfits being far more aggressive this time, although who knows if it's going to work out. They just back off, punish Reinforce early on, but it's very even. Manitin takes advantage of the early opening, but again, Volataya is unchecked. He's still in this fight, still at full health. It's got something to come down to value versus Manitin here in just a moment.
Yeah, Manitin putting on a clinic as the 76, but it's a low numbers fight now. Valu might be coming in here just to try to stall it out a little bit, but unnecessary. Decides to wait for a Steven Smith.
He valued his life a little bit more, but I did like that from Misfits. It's a much more decisive engage, and sure, they might have lost Reinforce in the process, but Manitin was there to back it up immediately, and it works out as Volataya gets a taste of his own medicine. Pulse Pistols right back in his face. With that early deflection kill, you already see Unite, they're gone. Like, they do not want to engage this here just yet until Volataya comes back, which is why they're just being a little bit careful holding in the back.
It's kind of a holdover maybe a little bit, and it's a little speculation of how they used to play as Reunited way back in the day, a very focused on team engagement. We're not gonna scrap it out. If we can reset, let's take six. We're confident in our game plan as a six-man squad more than we are on our just individual, I'm gonna 1v1 you kind of thing.
Well, Reinforce getting punished on a counter dive there. Already a 6v5 opportunity for Reunited. They're gonna pull the attack visor and see if this is enough to equalize, but much better opening here from United. They get the early kills they need. It's 3-1, and Tvik is moving around. It's just a little bit of delay, but there's nowhere he can go. Surrounded by enemies on all sides, United well on their way to retaking control at this point.
They did already have to cede about 54% there, though. And it was a slow start for Valu as he died to a deflect. I think that he's just feeling it right now. He doesn't even think deflect exists. If you're Valu, you believe that your bullets can go through blades at this point.
Yeah, I mean, his bullets, it's not even bullets anymore. They're just extensions of his will. But the next fight is going to be taking place here in just a second. Misfits coming back in. Dragon Blade is up. Nevix, Unchained. The blade is in, looking for Zen, but the sound barrier. Wasting his time, he gets a foot to the face. Boombox using those feet to great advantage. Oh my goodness, so close yet so far coming out there from Nevix.
It's the most humiliating melee in the game by far. Everyone else is like a little slap and it hurts a lot, but the foot to the face.
Look, Zenyatta keeps exceptionally clean feet. He's floating all the time. Like, you don't have to worry about it. It's a cleaner depth than you might think.
Probably still has to take his shoes off in some places. Actually, I don't even think he wears shoes.
I don't think he has shoes. It's his thing. In any case, right now, United in firm control of the point, but Misfits starting to break through again. They get one kill early on as they come back in, and now they have to get on the point. It's just barely Morte coming in the contest. And it's a bit of a skirmish, but it's one that Misfits has a numerical advantage on. So it is likely United's gonna have to give this one up.
A little bit of pressure on the point caused them to throw their Lucio into it, but no one went with him onto the point. I think that could have been a rotation that they went with. They obviously valued just keeping the Transcend up to get out there. It was a little bit interesting because I thought they really could have taken that skirmish. Now Manitin being pressured on very hard by the Winston, getting all the heals that he needs. And meanwhile, it's been flipped back over for United.
This is still okay for Misfits. Misfits has a buffer of about two fights. They can lose one fight and still come back, flip the point, and take this first round. The thing for them is that they don't want to throw ultimates after bad here. They might poke in, then die, but then come back and attack visor. But no, Manitin, he's gonna use attack visor immediately here. They are all or nothing, but it is going to be nothing as Volataya decimates the backline here once more. Two kills here from United. And though they get more than perhaps expected, it's a really rough beginning where Manitin really didn't have anything to shoot at there with his attack visor.
Cruz might have experienced a little bit of lag or got himself a little bit out of position, and Tvik will punish him for it as Tvik tries to single-handedly bring this back. That is two kills already on his Lonesome, and now getting a lot of damage going on. Unfix is gonna pop this with the Primal Rage going on the points, somehow able to get one or two. They've yet to flip this back over, and now it's becoming a very scrappy exchange on the points.
It's a scrappy exchange. Misfits is definitely in the driver's seat here. Tevik was spotted carrying a backpack going into that last fight, so it's working out for Misfits. Now, Reunited, it's not going to be great engage, but they do have the opportunity to come in here once more. Misfits, they have the advantage to shut this down. A good Transcendence Dragon Blade should be night-night here for Reunited, but will be executed well. There's a sound barrier. Nevik still holding on to the blade, but so much can be used here for Misfits still. There's the blade. They get the first kill, and this is going about as expected so far.
Oh no. I don't know what happened to Morte there. It's an odd break it down, but he's able to climb back up. Magic roller blades are very useful. They also transcend on the point, but despite those support ultimates coming in, it's not the follow through for their team. That was not the cleanest looking of engagements from Reunited. Morte was in an odd position, broke it down by himself, fell into the cliff, maybe scoping out where that gold is, came back out just seconds off on their coordination on some of that.
Well, I think the reason why it was is that they just didn't have time. Quickly, it was going to be Misfits map. They had to get in and contest, and anytime you're under that level of time pressure, you don't have the ability to set the terms of your engagement perhaps the way that you would like to. And in the end, even though Reunited made that very close, you see the power of getting ahead early in control, where Misfits had time to give, they were able to build up an advantage, and then they were able to execute in a very good way at the very end.
Well, that is first stage for Misfits, and they needed that one. They needed the confidence that they could be this Reunited team after getting full health on Gibraltar. And, you know, there is a mental aspect to this whole game, as evidenced by some of the stuff that goes on between these teams behind the scenes and relationships. So you have to have mental strength here. Both teams diving early on, getting all of that cleave damage. This is how you always see this map open.
Misfits coming in with a much better flanking position here, and yet they don't come out unscathed. Reinforce has to give up his life as 5v5 as Reunited takes refuge here in the building. The onslaught from Misfits, absolutely relentless here. And finally, they get their men. They will make that into a party room of death. As a result, Misfits on the verge of taking this first point, although Volitaya still alive and waiting in the wings.
And this is why I don't mind not getting invited to your parties, because I just don't understand how it's ever a party room. Room of death, totally get. Completely makes sense to me. Party room of death? CP, I don't know what you're into, but maybe that's why my invites keep getting lost in the mail.
You know what? I wouldn't worry about it too much, but I do want to see you at the party this weekend. Pulse Bomb coming out here from Valtaya, opening things up. Mineral down to start things off. And Valu again going off into the back. It's three kills for Valtaya. Everyone in his sights. And that is going to be Reunited striking right back in a much more timely fashion this time. Only 23% to Misfits.
They're on the chase here too. That was a super aggressive chase. They used the Lucio speed boost just to hunt down Tevik. It's not about getting the kill, it's about sending a message, and Tevik not safe sitting back there on the Mega.
Tevik going, why you have to do this? Like, hostilities are over, the war was won. He was just an innocent bystander at that point, but in any case, Reunited in a firm position here. They have both support ultimates up for this next fight. Ideally, they would like to just only burn one, but they can burn two to maintain control. No, they almost give up control of the point in the beginning, just barely catching that in time.
Tevik will get 1 pound of flesh in here, but still the numbers have gone in favor. Tevik is wearing not only a backpack, but maybe a baby Bjorn too. He's doing his best to take everyone with him, drag them all to victory, but it's not quite enough. The late sound barrier comes in, and we're gonna try to get back on this point.
Misfits has picked away at Reunited here bit by bit, and even though Reunited has a lot of ultimates in reserve, they haven't really been interested in using them except for now. The sound barrier comes in, and the transcends might be in soon, but it's a little bit late. I mean, if you're gonna use the sound barrier, use it before you lose two people.
It's a little bit late, but they should have enough here. They finally have enough to clean up. The dash throughs will come in and evict them from the point, and again on the chase too. I wonder if this is a new thing that we'll see a little bit more of, because I think there are times where teams get away with retreats that they shouldn't, and this is a long map where you can make that dive work, and we've seen both teams now use speed boosts and really get their chase going.
No doubt about it. Sometimes you just gotta hunt down the survivors, X, but...
Don't invite me to your party!
Well, don't try and survive the party, X. I don't know what you want from me. But Reunited coming back in here once more. Misfits, though, tools to both delay this with Primal Rage and win. But they lose Nevix immediately. There will be no Blade. Reunited striking first here in this fight. And they double down here at the Transcendence. They want to take this right here and right now. Still a bit of delay coming out here from Reinforce, but all his friends are swiftly dying, Hex. Much like people at my parties.
I'm unavailable this weekend. I have prior engagements. The point is, trying to get Flip back over. It is certainly in control of Misfits, and those two kills right there should lock it up. And now you have to really wonder if you're even safe to retreat nowadays. They are. They're able to get out as a squad of three. Tavik doing a little hunting of his own, setting up on the side here, trying to probably get one of those pulse bombs. His pulse bombs have either been great or throwaways, just complete throwaways.
Well, right now, if it could be great, Tavik holds the keys to ending this round in favor of Misfits and putting them that much closer to forcing a third map. So we'll see what Tavik has up his sleeves here. Can he land a good pulse bomb? No, it does not connect the way it wants.
Got him.
Volataya, though, does connect his pulse bomb on the mineral, and that gives life to E-United here, where they don't have anything left to give. This is a must-win fight, but it does look like they're winning.
Yeah, tale of two pulse bombs, as you mentioned. We are in that kind of meta where those bombs and those blades mean so much. And Sharp actually finally showing up, gets all the cleave damage and the clean up. This is going to be pretty close. It's at 70%, but the way these fights have been being dragged out, I'd say that this next fight will decide the stage.
This next fight will almost certainly decide the course of the stage, and it's looking good for E-United. They are in a much stronger positioning. Misfits is going to have to get an early pickup here before Transcendence comes into play. Otherwise, it's going to be very difficult to do this. They're going to open up a Transcendence of their own. A counter Transcendence is out. The Self-Destruct is in. Both teams dropping ultimates early on here, and yet Misfits able to stay alive at six, but for how long? Mineral under heavy pressure into the back. Oh, Shriek just takes down Zebosai and Angry Winston in a close quarter situation. Not what you want to fight. Five versus five, but Volataya opened up to go around, as it is going to be unfixed just with what will be the round winning cleanup.
Baby Diva taking a ride on E-United Airlines there, getting reaccommodated off the edge. Topical.
So, United able to even things out, and that was a round where Misfits did have the opportunity to put that one away. Certainly, Ultimate Flow towards the end went a bit against them, but now instead of being up 2-0 with two rounds to give, it is even 1-1. Could be any team's map.
I think, we talk so much about the Tracers, and duly so. It has been a battle of Tracers. Oftentimes, control maps are. I thought Shriek there did a lot of damage, both opening fights and closing fights, getting out and then being able to come back in alive. And I think a lot of credit needs to be given to probably both Winstons. I think Reinforce has also had himself a decent game so far, so they will be the ones to watch if you're tired of watching British time travelers.
Sometimes we like talking about the problem. Neither Winston has been the problem
right
so far.
Absolutely.
Both teams sizing each other up here on the Shrine on the Pall. Neither team actually going too deep into each other, but here comes United Shriek. Going to lead the way, the first one in, but the first one dead. Reinforce goes back to help his team. A bit of a counter engage here from Misfits that could pay heavy dividends here. As you take a look at United, they are getting pushed back. They don't have their Winston anymore. They have to deal with a fully fledged Misfits team, and they're just getting bullied off the point.
In these kind of compositions, it's so difficult once you lose your Winston. However, they equalize as Cruz comes back, takes down Reinforce.
Well, the scary thing here is that Shriek's going to be back in a moment, so the shoe's going to be on the other foot, and Misfits is getting thrown back, so they weren't able to capitalize on that advantage. They went a little bit too far deep, and E-United just backs up enough to create their own opportunity and come right back in.
Oftentimes, during the 2-2-2 meta, I said you never want to lose all of anything. And when you're only running a single tank in these situations, losing your Winston early on is terrible. And you need to capitalize on that immediately. They had the advantage where there wasn't going to be space control, there wasn't going to be cleave, and they didn't get the kills quick enough, as you mentioned. Shriek comes in, and he combines and helps out for a couple kills late.
You think for Misfits in the last fight, they had great health too, and they had six. They just weren't able to play it properly. In any case, they are coming back in here once more, looking for the way in. Pulse bomb out from Tavik, and it hits Pager. Shriek out of the fight, but the rest of the fight not going very well at all, as the flankers of E-United just crush the back line of Misfits. Cruz and Valtaya might even share a mutual high five after that one.
Tavik did what he could, got a couple, but he can't do it all right there. And I think they're focusing very well on shutting him down. And I think what might be giving him fits, as good as Zebu is on his end, Boombox, I think, is on another level lately. And it's so frustrating as a Tracer to not be able to consistently finish the other Zen.
We talked about DPS winning fights that you shouldn't win, but when your Zenyatta is able to just take someone down in the beginning of a fight, well, that's usually a one fight, free contribution from your supports. Next fight here, though, is underway. Manitin with the big guns. The tactical visor is out. looking for targets in the back, will be zoning out United if nothing else. And yet, you take a look, Boombot just able to stop Manitin and be that equalizing force once more, Hex, as you were just mentioning.
I think they're going to try to get a little bit of stall out here. Most of the kills have gone in favor, but this might be a time where United just hangs out a little on the point, saves their ultimates. I mean, Pulse Bomb you can throw out if you want to be a Hero Valor. No one's going to blame you for that. But look, he's just blinking around. He is going to toss it out. Doesn't matter much. He's going to get taken out late, but they wanted to save a couple alts, get it to 89. One more fight wins them the stage.
So this is hard mode here for Misfits, where they must ration their ultimates. They could win the next fight by burning everything, and that would be a gigantic win for United. This is tricky, because if they lose one more major fight, they're going to lose the round, and they will be in the hole. So Misfits must do this properly, but look at that. Boombox finds Zeppo immediately, and now they have to burn everything just for a chance of staying alive in this fight.
Yeah, that is the light that says go, but the engagement will come in. Boombox gets another kill onto Vic, who went back there. Yes, he leaves him the parting gift, but Boombox is probably fine with that. He has gotten two important kills, all in favor of United right now. Misfits has to find something just to stall out.
People thought boomboxes went out of style in the 90s, but it is 2017, and this boombox is banging right now as E-United is able to come back in, retake control of the point. We'll see if Misfits can even stall this out, but they are running into a meat grinder, even if they do. As you see Cruz moving in, the blade is out, slicing his way through, bit deflection into the back, a little bit of rifle butt in his face as Misfits desperately looking for a way of keeping this round in contest, but overtime is ticking away, and they get onto it just in time. Only to die.
Only to die. We need to check Google Trends later, since Boombox has been playing Overwatch, to see how many people have Googled what is a boombox. I think we might be dating ourselves a little bit. You know, sometimes you just take your tape out of the boombox, put it in your Walkman, go down to the roller rink, do a couple jams on the rollerblades, you know.
Oh, the 90s. Also, everything was extreme.
Yeah, everything was extreme. They could sell you eggs with a guitar riff in the 90s.
We're old.
Well, at least we can laugh about it.
I cry about it later on.
Yeah. United on the verge right now, and you just see this is all the stall coming in, but it's a futile attempt on Fix again. Everyone's getting discorded and then buy. It's just so simple, and you really can't say enough about Boombox. You really can't. That level of Zen play is what you expect to see out of Europe. They all run Zen, and Boombox is probably the best Zen in Europe right now. I mean, it's hard to argue with the results.
Oh, my God! Are you kidding me? Boombox!
Stop it.
Okay.
Stop it.
This is just, I don't even, Misfits is losing people early on these fights from incredibly well-timed Zen charges. This is brutal. United is getting fights for free off of what Boombox is doing.
I don't even know why they run a Widow on some maps. Why not just let Boombox do what he does? It's clearly his best attribute. He's got some sort of scope going on in his Zenyatta.
He is one in the iris, or whatever Zenyatta likes to say there. I don't know. It's very spiritual for a guy who's killing everyone. In any case, United still in firm control of the point. Cruz might be down early on, but Valtaya falling to Tevik. Tevik getting a little bit of revenge there, and this will open up Misfits to reverse course here in this fight as Tevik cuts the music as Boombox is down.
Yeah, Tevik, we've said he has a backpack, a baby door, might as well add a fanny pack to it. He's doing his best to just carry this team as much as he can. Get some nice contribution from Manitin and Zebo here towards the end. But when they are winning fights, it is 2 and 3 kills from Tevik.
Tevik is the poor dad on vacation who's just loaded up with everything just in case. You know, 8 water bottles, 2 things of sunscreen, and Band-Aids just because, you know, the kids might get in danger. I don't know, but Tevik is certainly carrying a lot at the moment.
At some point in your life, you just become a pack mule and you accept it. Well, that's a nice kill to enter into. And Cruz was going for something, does not find anything. He just finds mineral right in his face. Only one kill does not mean they're going to fully reset, but they're going to wait a second. Minerals should be, or you should be able to join the fight shortly should Cruz back into this. And I think they like their odds better as 6.
Well, Misfit certainly has a bit of an edge going into this. They have the Tac Visor to back up the Transcendence. It's going to be Transcendence on both sides, unlikely. And the first one comes out from United. Boombox leading his way in. Zebosai countering. Everyone really happily not dying in the middle of that. But now the death can begin. The Transcendence is over and cruises into the back. But it's a control coming out from Reinforce. Yeah. Not one, but 2 Primal Rage kills as he bops United all the way off at this point.
Yeah, I think Zebo heard some of the praise we were heaping upon Boombox and decided he wanted a slice of that pie too, as over the last several minutes, he's gotten 4 or 5 kills of his own. And now they're in a pretty good position holding here. It's one of the harder maps to re-engage on, right? Coming through main is your best option. The other options are not so great. But coming through main, you're going to take so much cleave. Nice starting kill by Valu.
Zebo is down immediately, but Nevix with the equalizer, and he has a blade if necessary. However, Cruz and Shariq finding their way to the back line and just removing Misfits from this point. And yet for Misfits, they're totally okay with this. They have a buffer zone of at least two fights here. Plenty of time to get the one final fight they need to turn this map in their favor.
But to the point I was just saying, entrance on this map is so difficult, especially running single tanks here. You're just looking for a kill, an errant dive to come in, but they're holding pretty far back. They're getting free entry. I don't know if I like that.
No, usually it's better to punish teams a little bit more, but United has been making Misfits their own worst enemy by backing up and punishing their engages. Reinforce is going to be the first one in, but United kind of wanted them to move in, and they're there at the punish. They stop Nevix right off the dive, and now, off the sound barrier, they have a 6-4, so it's not just dive versus dive for United. They're more than willing to punish your dive as Unfixed treats to Vic to the Helix special.
And the way they catch the dive so softly is interesting, because a lot of teams will come back with their Winston. They sent their Winston instant to the other side of the map to pressure out Zebo so that he wasn't a factor in that fight, so that he can't get the orbs going the way they want, and eventually they just took him out with Winston versus Zen 1v1.
Well, this could be the final fight here on the way. Misfits pressuring in, Transcendence and Tac Visor leading the way, but United, they clear out! They are out of there immediately! They don't give any value to that immediately, and here comes the Dragon Blade, but it might be late. Divic finally hit a bit of power there, and Cruz, he's out of it.
Power spiking down into looking for the golds. If anyone knows it's down there, it would be Zenyatta. Misfits able to get that fight. Maybe. Well, I don't know anymore, because that pulse bomb could have been nice for some stall out. I don't think they're even going to get back to the point.
It's going to be difficult for United to touch a point here again. Misfits knows it. That's why they're coming out here. And look at this. Shariq gets the point just in time. Crosses the plane. We are in overtime. And Zebo is down. United might be bringing this back after an incredibly epic dive from Shariq. Who knows where we're going here, Hexes. Shariq has two. Cruz piling on the Dragon Blade. Misfits thought they had this one, but they are getting rejected by United here.
What was Winston's icon from the Summer Games? Because it should be triple jump. Because that was insane, a beautiful leap, a reset from Primal Rage. Elite back on, takes control of the points.
And now it's Misfits on the back foot, down players, desperately delaying. Mineral gives up his life for the cause. Manitin sliced into pieces, and E-United brings it back after one of the most epic Winston leaps we have seen.
It's perfectly timed. Primal Rage resets your jump, leaps in, resets it, jumps onto the point, triple jump champion of the world. And I just love how they run their dive. And it's a lot about giving Shariq freedom. Because most North American teams anyway, if you're gonna catch the dive, like catching a hockey puck, right? Just catch it on your stick. You come back and you come with everyone back and you need that cleave damage. And they catch it with all their DPS, play it really smart, and then say, Shriek, go make sure that their Zen can't play with us. And that's all he did. He just jumped in.
Yeah. I just like imagining that all the hopes and dreams for EU Nano on Shriek, because, you know, Winston does that big thing where he, like, spreads his arms out. He's and he got there just in the nick of time. I mean, I'd almost want a traditional sports-level replay of the clock juxtaposed.